In this video demonstration, we will look at planning and deploying the Virtual Machine Manager 2008R2. We'll plan for the implementation of VMM2008R2 based upon organizational requirements. We'll install and configure the VMM components, and we'll manage hosts and host groups. So the first thing that we want to do is install and configure the VMM components. So I'm going to go into the configuration analyzer, and we're just going to check to make sure that this machine is capable of running System Center Virtual Machine Manager 2008R2. And we can see that there's no configuration issues found. Okay, so we'll close down this window and we'll go ahead and install the product. Now to do this, I need to connect up to the share, which is on a remote machine. So I'm going to type in the UNC path, NYC, host 1, / and we'll just go into the administrative share for E. From there, I'm going to go into program files, Microsoft Learning, 10215, lab files, and in there we've got our System Center Virtual Machine Manager. From there, I'll run setup as the administrator. Okay, now what we'll notice here is there are a number of components for System Center. We're going to install the server component and the administrative console. So, from the server component, we'll just flick through the wizard. We don't want to participate in the customer experience program. We just type in administrative under product registration and can toss over the company. And then next, see there's no issues with the prerequisite check. Next on the location, and under SQL Server, we're going to choose to install 2005 Express Edition. We're next through the library share, next on the installation settings, next on the summary, and installation begins. Okay, with that done, let's come out of the wizard. And now we want to run the administrator console setup. So again, we'll accept the end user license agreement. We don't want to use Microsoft Update. And we're next through the wizard. So I'm accepting all the defaults here. We're just next and install. Okay, now that's completed, let's exit out of the setup. And what we want to do is we want to go into the administration console and we're going to look at configuring a delegated administration user role. So we'll just wait for the console to initialize. Now to do this, I'm going to go into administration. I'm going to click on user roles. And from here, I'm going to select a new user role. For the user role name, I'm going to type in IT admin support, and I want to make them a delegated administrator, so I'm going to change the user role profile. From here I'll click next. You can't see this on the screen because of the resolution, so I'm having a tab to the next button. We're going to add some users in, and I'm going to add Andrea into this group. And then under the scope, I'm going to do it for all hosts and all libraries. And we can see that's completed. Okay, so now what we'll do is we create a host and host groups. So we're going to go into host, we're going to create a new host group. I'm just going to call this Contoso. And with our host group created, let's go ahead and add some hosts to the host group. Okay, so we'll select the host location. We're going to type in our administrator username, password, and domain. For the computer name, I'm going to select NYC host 1. And we'll add that in. I'm also going to add NYC host 2. From there, we select Next. And there's a warning about Hyper-V, but that's fine, so we just click Yes. For the host group, I'm going to add these machines to Contoso. Under the host properties, I'm going to add the following path, /vm, just as a default path. And then under Summary, add hosts. Now we can see what VMM is actually doing, because it's actually using PowerShell commands. So we can see the script that's about to run. I'll close that down and we'll choose to add the hosts. Okay, the job will begin. And we can see that that's completed successfully. So now what I'm going to do is manage the host and host group. So I'm going to go into NYC host 2. I'm going to choose to go into properties. And from here I'm going to click on the tab. So the first tab we'll look at is status, and we can see that everything is happy. Under VMs, we'll look at reserves. Now what I want to do is I want to change the reserve memory, and I'm going to change that to 768. Under disk space, I'm going to change that to 500 megabytes. And then under networking, I'm going to add a new network, and I'm just going to call this test private network. Just spell that right. Test private network. For the network tag, I'll give it a tag of 7. And for the description, I'm just going to call this network for evaluation purposes. Under the placement, we can see our default path, but I'm going to select a new path. So I want to go into E. And from here, I'm going to create a new folder. I'm just going to call this VM1. Okay, from there we'll expand this. We'll select our VM1, and we can see we've now got two paths. From there we're okay. We'll go to the properties of Contoso. We can see our members. If I click on host reserves, we can see global host reserves. I'm just going to change CPU percentage down to 15, network capacity up to 15. The last tab is Pro, Performance, Resource and Optimization. And this is what we're going to look at later when we look at SCOM.